Welcome everyone to RGN here for the Pro Series 2016 European Open Qualifier Round of 16 action. I am Sprawl, joined by Laser Jesus, and we got Leisure versus Isuba. I'm excited to see what's going to go on here. We got Cobblestone up first, and I do believe that is the map choice of Leisure. Yeah, and then we got Cash coming up next for Isuba, and then third would be Mirage if we're live into the pistol.
I'm not sure if I'm thinking of one of our previous tournaments, but did we just recently see Leisure on Cobble?
I think it was one of our previous tournaments. I think that was some time ago.
Okay, so my memory's a little hazy with them. Anyways, so far this round, we got the B take, or the B fake from Leisure, dealt with on that front, but over towards the A side, and now Faker comes through connector with the flank. If he can get any more done, that is massive. Or the Leisure side, and just two more players remaining for Isuba. With that smoke, they need to make use of it.
Let's see if they can get this done. Hinky taking a lot of damage, and his teammate's gonna go down as well. So M&L with three frags, and they make it work on the A bomb site, and yeah, quite a bit of work done in connector. Even though it was just a one frag, kind of throwing them off a little bit, and it was enough to, again, create that 3-on-2.
The timing of it was made it so good. Right when the rotate comes through, it's hard when you're taking out from that drop room to time that correctly, because you don't want to go down without getting a frag. Say you drop down into connector and then a player that's rotating from B shoots you in the back. So nicely timed. The drop down player from Leisure, not sure what M&L's waiting for. Maybe just sorting some settings out. He had the bomb and the rest of his squad was already rushing up towards B. But for the force buy from Isuba, this one man, Monty, not force buying. Oh, he actually dropped a FAMAS over to Henke. So a lot of pressure on Henke to make that worth it.
Right. He's going to play towards drop, and he gets nothing done for his efforts. Actually, they are probably going to retrieve that FAMAS, actually. So more or less donated it into the T's hands. And do you like the position he played with it? Just towards the drop down? I feel like maybe towards, like, broken wall, where he can maybe take a long distance duel versus a MAC-10 a little bit better. But nonetheless, they are bringing it back a little bit, but very lit are the remaining CTs. But here we go, 2-on-2.
I can do it. They have the upgraded pistols, and now it's just one player that's Remux, and he's quite low. RDO, last guy for the CTs. Again, both players so wounded. Remux wants to take a new position, but by doing so, he's going to allow the CT to take a new position himself. Both players creeping around the rectangle. This will be for the round. And with 5 HP remaining, Remux, I think he tried to tap him with the 5-7, but Deagle prevails.
Yeah, I can't believe that ended up working out, but Isuba's going to be very happy about that, obviously. And that kind of negates all the talk that I was going to bring up about that FAMAS. That was not the impactful part at all. I don't think it even really got much damage into one of the players. It was more just the pistol game, so nice work on the CT side, and that's good news for Isuba. Again, Leisure's map choice, so they wanted that comfortable pistol round and then the 3-round start. It will be forced by and to follow, so maybe we'll see some back and forth as Faker does find a frag.
So just quickly, getting Galil's out right back at him. And I think Leisure dropped some of those Galil's over from their other players, or maybe the money was just a bit staggered. But looks like both teams are employing that strategy where one of your players will go with a pistol, drop one of your teammates a rifle. A 1-for-1, 2-for-2. The Leisure still trying to probe their way out the broken wall. I'm not sure if the bomb can be saw or seen by the CT side, but they've committed the bomb and two others while bringing some players over towards A. So the bomb has gone down. Now Isuba will realize, well, where are they? If they're not by the bomb, they must be flanking.
Yeah, and again, pretty aware to it. You got Freddy inside a drop. Should be able to win this duel versus M&L. See how it pans out as he does show his shoulder. A little bit of maybe premature spray there. But it will be the T taking the fight. No HP really left on him, though, as his teammate goes down. And 30 seconds to get it done. Should be Isuba able to pick up another round here as M&L slowly creeps up towards that rock area. He does spot out a player and drops him. Now only BenQ, and for the spam here is the T. The nade should soften him up a little bit. Does take him down to half, but with 10 seconds remaining, needs to take that duel soon. Puts even more damage into him now, looking for the Deeg, because Ran out of ammunition. Put even more, and I can't believe BenQ just never took a duel. He just played completely passive and allowed that 1v1 to go to leisure.
You see, players fall victim to that quite often. When the time gets so low and you're the one whose time is giving the favor to, it can make you a little stiff, and he didn't want to take the fight that entire time, and he had a significant HP advantage. Maybe he didn't know that. Maybe that would have made him peak. But yeah, you see a lot of players get made stiff by that low clock.
Interesting stuff. It's leisure. Gonna be happy. We'll take him that round, but back and forth we go. The battle of forces here, as RDO does go down towards long A. Freddy trades off, but goes down to Faker from that danger stair position. So now 3-on-4. We're gonna see Leisure able to take this one. Unless Monty BenQ can come up big, we'll create a 2-on-3, but BenQ's teammate's so far away.
And Leisure has struggled to these sort of pistols from Isuba. This time the players are more split up than what happened at the B-bomb site, which lost them the round. Monty coming out connector with the 5-7. Here's a player at long too, so he wants to isolate that one. Will, so MNL does fall victim to the 5-7, but that'll be it for the end of the round. 3-1 for the Leisure side, and I think we're finally going to see a save out from one of these two teams once Leisure establishes a decent bank here.
They did get 3 frags in the round, but yeah, it doesn't warrant force buy from that CT side. Just going to see the actual save. Leisure with plenty of equipment. They've got light with the AWP, actually. You know, pick towards A middle. A lot of presence towards the B bomb site for the CT side. Trying to work a boost towards drop down. Henke up on the shoulders of his teammate. Not going to fully commit and go over the boost. Oh, and I lied. He does commit to it. That being said, Freddy's going to get some action here. Should be able to call some players on the other side of the smoke. Spams a little bit. Doesn't find anybody. But again, should be able to call that. It's quite a few trying to make it up A.
Man, Freddy's got the moves here inside of the stairs. Leisure will deal with him, but he just peeked back and forth so many times, jumping up the stairs, jumping down the stairs. I'm sure it looked funny to whoever was posted up from Leisure at the bottom of mid. And RDO, there's the forced team kill. He just right. Runs out middle. Remux tries to shoot at him, but instead his teammate ends up being the target. Now, 4 for Leisure and a decent bank. Not the greatest, but still, Isuba, they're going to have to string 2 together. And if they do pick up this one, the economic cycle you can get caught in on Cobble. I think it's easier to get caught in it on Cobble more so than other maps because of how much you can switch up your T side immediately. Say, like, you go for an A default, it doesn't work. All right, let's just go for a hard B. And that makes the reset potential really hardcore here on Cobble.
Definitely Freddy taking a duel towards middle, not able to win it versus MNL as he tries to nade and fall back, take a new angle. But Leisure is going to be able to find their way up A. RDO still posted towards long A, but he will have teammates rotating in. Henke and Monty making their way over, but the rotation actually being called for the T side. And it'll be BenQ to have to call out that at some point here he's going to get some more attention.
If this player at B goes down, they might want to just think about a save. There's still a lot of mollies left. 1-4, the White Rock. Now they're going to begin to push out into the bomb site. They are allowing Isuba time to rotate these players over. They're not instantly busting into the bomb site, but Isuba, yeah, you're getting the players into the site, but there's still significant numbers, and oh, wow. They just get wrecked. Everybody's waiting around the white box, and Leisure begin to peek.
Yeah, that was interesting. They got one frag, I think, from that rock position, just spamming into the smoke. Caught one player, but as soon as that happened, yeah, player kind of pushed towards Chicken Coop and was able to see past one of those smokes. Took a bunch down, and, well, they all fall. Leisure up 5-1. And considering Isuba was able to take the second round after pistol, this is definitely not the scoreline they were hoping for. They could still, in theory, bring it back, usually, especially if it's a map choice of one side. T side can be quite favored, but see how this proceeds. A couple deagles on the field for the CT side. Monty's going to be playing the chicken coop, looking for the one deag on light. Does put a body shot into him and a Flashbang rains out, but it'll be light and glittier to get the first frags. Henke with one, but it looks to be it. It's Freddy left with RDO and doesn't look like we'll get anything more. RDO taking some damage. Faker deals with him. Two frags for Faker and 6-1, keeping four alive. Economy's looking darn good for the T's.
Looking really good for Leisure, and how they got to this scoreline. Those first couple rounds were really decisive on who was going to get that opening advantage, and I wasn't impressed by Leisure's T side, especially on the first gun one where the rifles were out, and we saw them commit onto Broken Wall with three players with the bomb while having two players out long, and the bomb already went down towards long, or excuse me, towards Broken Wall. But since then, things have been looking good. Finally, another gun round for Isuba. As the op of RDO, he's pushed way up long. Not sure if Leisure are gonna commit to clearing this. Looks like Vladir is on his way. Freddy, the only other player at A, he's wounded. Now pushing up long, he needs to hit this shot. RDO, and he's at a bit of a one and done. Goes for the no scope. Vladir comes through with the flash, but he's pinched in and they're hot on his heels.
He does have a teammate Freddy with him, and he'll hit another shot. Very important. He stays alive in that position. And he's still kind of caught out, but if he can make it out, Freddy taking a duel versus Light will take him down. RDO with another one as he comes up from behind. Remux last one up, lagged. 1 HP remaining. RDO trying to find the quad kill, but will be denied. But again, looks like we will see the second round for the CT side. Wondering if Remux can make this any more expensive for the CTs, but with one hit point, it's hard to imagine.
If he does get any, it's going to cut the buy down significantly from Isuba. Wondering if my premonition of the switch up will come true. This Leisure, and they went with some of the slower work this round, and on Cobble, I was talking about it earlier, you can switch up that T side pace so significantly, and by doing so towards the B-bomb site, if you haven't executed quickly there yet, there's a lot of little nuances for teams on how they specifically take into that B-bomb site with a rush. It wouldn't surprise me to see that from Leisure in this upcoming round. And Remux, if he's not going to go for kills, I don't know why he's peeking at this point. Don't want to go down after the time, but maybe I'm just being picky. Two now for Isuba. They survive with three. Now, at least everybody will have guns, but this is a must-win for Isuba. Otherwise, the half is already lost.
Yeah. The good side, like you were saying, is that they survive with a bit, so they do have a little bit of economy, but not enough to get very much at all if they lose this round. So, a lot on the line. Freddy, that AWP off towards B. We'll play RDO solo. He's actually just going to play towards the bomb site. Very passive look. He's hopping around awkwardly. And playing towards connector now as Leisure. They're going to play slow towards B, not the maybe quick play we were expecting, but a little bit of nade damage already onto two of their players as they slowly post up, and yeah, nothing too quick here.
Yeah, they make a bunch of noise right away, and you see by the utility of the CT side, they used a ton of it just because they're worried about that opening fast towards B. So when the second wave comes through for Leisure and have less utility to deal with, specifically flashbangs, there's not a lot left for Isuba, just one on Henke. But if Freddy's hitting shots from the Broken Wall, not going to matter as much. They have to, for Leisure, deal with this guy on top of Broken Wall. And the bomb, he's the next target of this op. Meanwhile, Monty, and wow, Freddy, it's all him this round.
Yeah, big round from AWP on the CT side, MNL. See if he can take down anybody. Isuba would love to survive with everyone, but BenQ falls first and foremost. Freddy still holding the angle. As you can see, they're both crouch peeking towards each other. Flash comes out, but MNL still hits the shot. So they're giving him a bit of an opportunity here, as he will switch off to the AK. And 1v3 with 15 seconds. Time is definitely working against him at this point, as he needs to leap over off the Broken Wall, but that's their opportunity to fire at him, unfortunately, and he does get caught out. So CTs will survive with three. Doesn't make it any more expensive, but that will at least, it's much better than obviously the scenario before he gets those frags.
I still think we'll be at a similar spot with the economy, but this time Leisure, this is their last chance to potentially reset Isuba. So looking at that CT money, I guess three of the players, they might force buy upon losing. We'll find out. I think a lot of it'll have to do with how many players survive at the end of the round. So one man towards B for leisure. That's Remux. Gonna try to cause a distraction towards drop. Not gonna flank this time though. Just gonna drop a nade, announce his presence, and then immediately fall back towards the A bomb site. I kinda like that from leisure, and oh man, that's a round loss right then and there. Both A players get entried, and I think this is a save if you're Isuba. You're gonna have nothing the next round.
That was very bizarre. RDO was watching middle from the connector door, and he gets blindsided from long A, and I think he thought that Freddy was watching deep enough into long A that he wouldn't just get blindsided from it, because RDO died before Freddy did when Freddy was the one that was watching long A from bank truck, I thought. That looked very, very bizarre from the CT side, and we'll save with two remaining players.
Yeah, unfortunate for them. Maybe just miscommunication or something like that. Some operas do like to take the gamble while you're kind of float in that area. But I think the speed that Leisure took into the A-bomb site played into that as well. It was quite fast in comparison with how they usually do it. And Isuba struggling to keep these weapons. And just one will bring it into the next. But I think since that one survived, they... God, I just don't know if they'll go for the force buy here, because the T's economy, it's not like they killed all that many people in the previous round. And I guess they're just going to save it. And you can argue for either way, but with players at like 1,800, they can get away with just one save. But giving up another round at this point in the game is pretty bad.
Yeah, it's definitely not a fun spot. Could be eight here for Leisure. They do have Monty with that AK. If he can maybe take a fight early and win it and give them the player advantage, maybe they can have something go their way in the round. They're actually pushing BenQ through Broken Wall. So that's going to give them all the intel that their stack is more or less correctly placed. Freddy burning a little bit towards long A. But again, the setup, they're actually going to fall off of their close mid setup. So heading back to connector as BenQ calls out, here's one or two. And actually with that pick, it looks like the bomb will rotate back, so the stack will be effective yet again.
Yeah, Monty is here with the AK, so he's the man that has to do most of the work. There's one. And Remux tons the damage done by Monty and actually finishes him off. Now the bomb, now we're gonna hit reverse and go straight back to the A-bomb site. It's a question of how fast Isuba realized this. And no smoke for the cross for Leisure. Oh, there is one down, but that is their last smoke. And the CTs have now figured it out.
So three AKs to work with on that CT side. They've got two kits. This is definitely a situation that they might be able to pull back here, but with that smoke, and the position it was in did buy the T's quite a bit of time, but flashes raining over the wall. Freddy a little bit blind here. As we can see, one towards fence, one towards long, one in sight. Leisure with an excellent setup as RDO team kills.
Dang.
That's a ruthless one as Leisure. They get a little help from Isuba on that one.
Right? I thought for sure that, I mean, the hold wasn't going to be that good. The way Monty was looking with the AK, had a little bit for the retake. Leisure didn't have another smoke up. Eight rounds for Leisure and Isuba. Yeah, they got two rounds loss bonus. They're investing everything they have left into this round. So if Leisure take this, very strong half from them. Likely going to be at 10, maybe even more, depending on how the next two go. He's going for the dry op entry. Is Ait? I haven't had to say that guy's name yet. Is that how we're saying it? Ait?
Light.
Light? Oh, that's an L.
I think it's an L at the start.
I thought he was so. Maybe if it was from the hood or something.
If it's capital I, that'd be pretty sick as well. But I've been going with Light.
makes sense. I maybe thought he was from one of the more rougher parts.
Right.
Had some Ebonics or something like that.
Maybe
anyways,
there's some history there.
More entries with the op attempted. And similar results. Light. Not going to find it. Now this time, and I got to highlight, when Leisure is taking into B, sometimes Remux will flank and sometimes he'll fall back and just join his teammates. And that's really keeping the player at the B bomb site.
Henke, yeah, three frags. Gets that last one on to Faker and really shuts this down. That being said, Remux coming through connector. Monty, you can see you flicking back and forth. He will find the timing. So nice work by him, and leaves Light in 1v3 that will only have one to deal with. But Monty looking pretty good at the moment, and being that Light only has 15 hit points, does have an op, so maybe finds the instant pick, drops off the wall. Monty should be able to call this out as his teammates are coming around. Peek in the corner, and Monty does find it. So Isuba finding the fourth.
I feel like that corner that Monty is playing is just so forgettable. See a lot of players get caught by it. Isuba looking at both teams' money. Maybe if Leisure could take this, they could still have one of those monster halves like 10 or 11. But if Isuba wins this round, I mean, they're right back in the match. And if, especially if they win their T-side pistol, I mean, they're almost favored at that point. And this is still a big one for both teams. It's really going to dictate whether Leisure has a phenomenal half or if Isuba claw it back and make it a reasonable one for themselves. I mean, if they could put it at 7, that's fantastic given how we started. And going out dry out the ramp this time. No luck. RDO and Freddy shut it down. And Leisure at the entries towards A in recent times have not found much success. Vladir onto RDO. Quick trade by Henke, though. And Leisure, I mean, are they running out of ideas? Are they, because this is two rounds in a row where they've tried to just go for the dry pick into A.
I didn't really like how they tried to pick the middle ramp. They actually flashed RDO off of the connector angle. Actually, I'll go about it in a sec here. Light still has something to show for us, apparently, as he creates a one-on-two. BenQ's playing way at the back of A. And that's a difficult angle to predict if you are Light, as and still doesn't even have the bomb in his hands. Monty over towards the A bomb site, or sorry, the B bomb site, rather. So they are playing 1-1. I don't think they recognized that the bomb was down. I thought that they did, to be honest, but Light heading back up towards connector. He heads up into A here. Monty still with the correct read, if that was the case, but Light coming around. This is actually the most vulnerable angle for BenQ. But the whiff comes out from Light, and he can't hit the second shot. Hops in towards the bomb site, and he does hit the no-scope. So that's one way of going about it, and creates now a one-on-one.
And he's not even going to go for the plant. He doesn't have time to do this, and Monty jukes him so good.
Wow.
And he knows, I mean, in that situation, it comes down to Monty. If he continues to peek and Light commits to the plant, well, Monty's probably going to get a free kill because he's planting. So Light, he realizes, well, I could go for the shot, and if he's peeking me, that's probably my best chance of winning the round. But Monty, all of that's in his mind, and he just doesn't peek.
And Light dies after the time, so he had $350, buys a P250, and that's it. But yeah, the way they pushed out middle, so they flash out once, and it fully white screens RDO. Like, he couldn't, he tried to avoid it, but couldn't. So it pushes him off the angle. They wait, and then flash again, and then go out, and the second flash didn't hit him at all. So it's kind of a weird way that they timed it. I wish they'd just committed on their first flash that they went on. But anyhow, looks like they are storming it to B, and it's actually working out very, very well. So I'll shut up about the last round.
All right, back to this round. Now, whoa, what a play by Remux. He just jumps out of the rectangle. Wow. They're in the 4-on-3 advantage, and Remux just...
What a round.
Just rushes through. I mean, you usually don't go for that when you're up that much. Just running through a smoke, jumping over a rectangle. And it's a round like that. Leisure go with a Tech 9 Rush B, and they do it this late in the half. So it begs the question, should they have done it with AKs earlier? Was this a weakness that they didn't even know was there this entire time? Because if it works with Tech 9s and limited utility, theoretically it should work better with full equipment.
Yeah, exactly. And, well, they will put their ninth on the board because of it. They will swap up and head back towards A. So just different looks back and forth here. And they're going to storm up long A. And this actually, a few rounds back, again, we had a round where long A was the entry point where they had players at middle, but long A was the first point to make contact. And again, they just storm players up long, ignore middle. They do lose the bomb there, but in the end, I think they're going to be able to make this work as it's only BenQ. And yeah, he's caught out. 10-5.
I wonder if BenQ had that name before. I mean, maybe it's his name or something, like his real name. That's a strange thing to name yourself just after a product.
Well, I wonder if it's just Bankin, we're just like mispronouncing it or something, or yeah, I really don't know.
That's probably why I put the one.
Maybe
there.
His first name is Ben and his last name starts with Q, so he's like, I actually like, yeah, I don't know, deserve it as much as they do. I have no idea. I'm Ben. Serializing.
Ben Q. What a name to come into esports with.
That'd be like great,
it. Right? So Isuba. Five, yeah, it gives them a chance. But it puts so much pressure on pistol round or the force bar round, because you can have an amazing T side, but if you get shut down early and you're already at a deficit, well, you don't get a lot of room to play. And a lot of teams, like the comebacks, are some of their strengths, and getting to identify or get a feel for what the CT side is doing and then adapting. But if Isuba don't win pistol, they probably won't get a lot of time to do so.
Definitely, and well, we're gonna see Freddy able to blindside Ladir as he tried to push out long A. So it's a good start here for Isuba. As now we'll see this, the setup's going to be two towards each bomb site, one at connector door, one at drop. Those are kind of the more centered players, if you will. And then we've got Faker and Light working more of the extremities. Light peeking towards broken wall. Freddy is holding the angle. I don't think you spotted out as Remux boosting up onto that tree location. See if he can make that. Oh, Light. Peeks out once, sees Freddy, identifies his target, and takes him down with the next swift peek.
Right, both players tried to pre-fire each other, but Light's the one to win the duel. So noise made towards drop, and then quickly out middle, but Faker's in a good spot if they don't check to the right. Faker, he's just missing though. There's too many targets for him. He only gets one. He could have ended the round right then and there. But still, there's a firing squad at top mid, but they're not peeking together. MNL goes down trying to hold the top of the hill while the rest of his teammates fall back.
Yeah, 2-on-2. Still, Leisure could make this work. The bomb is going down. Isuba, I think BenQ. Oh, BenQ gets... Wow. Annihilated from Light. Now it's only Monty 1v2. He's stuck on the bomb site and they know exactly where he is. So honestly, opportunities he has, not much. He tries to go for the fake flash with the decoy, finds the first one. Light going for the up and overplay, and he will be able to catch Monty out in the end. 4k for Light. And yeah, that round could have gone so many different ways, and especially considering that mid play that you were highlighting. Was it Faker that was down there? Yeah, he was got one frag, but imagine he doesn't take any shots and just, again, slowly, carefully lines up more than that. He just kind of freaked out a bit.
Yeah, Faker could have ended the round then, and then MNL, he's like playing King of the Hill or something. He just wants to hold it while the rest of his team falls back. Maybe they had to reload and he still had a full clip, something like that, but usually everybody will stand together. Ends up working out in the end in Light. This guy's aim is robotic with pistols, it seems, and he wants to take more fights towards the broken wall. This time, spot somebody out. No,
Oh.
What?
So, I guess there's some mixed ideas there. Someone thought push broken wall, someone thought nade broken wall.
And I think MNL is not even in the voice comms, because that's two rounds in a row where he's just separated from his team.
And this, again, goes down to a nade. So, sad times. Not a good start here for Leisure. Maybe Isuba can take advantage of the miscommunication. And they are going to head towards B. Three players here, though, and Light is at the end of the broken wall. Starts spraying. Only, actually, he doesn't get anything. It's Remux that gets one. And now a 4-on-2. Very favorable to the T side. But, to be fair, they are very lit.
Oh, through the smoke. Faker. Nobody's getting any kills, though, for Leisure. And they've had multiple targets. The utility has really helped out Isuba make this round doable and favorable at this point, but Ladir spins around onto Monty. There's two players left so wounded. Is Isuba? He finds another one through the smoke. He doesn't have a kit, though. He's got to get his move on. Needs to check towards the broken. He's trying to hide. Oh, he doesn't check the right way. Freddy saves the round, but almost from Ladir. At least he made a ton of money for himself.
Yeah, no doubt. And almost made it work nice from Isuba, considering, again, they were all solo. Luckily for Freddy, he was in a position where he could kind of escape more so than the rest of the players, so played passive way down the broken wall. Worked out well. We'll see a Nova being put in play here and such. That's quite interesting.
Where's he going with that? I guess Tor's broken.
Yeah, I assume so, but...
The guy's had some interesting ideas so far. We've seen him make two plays now in recent times that are... It doesn't seem like his teammates had any idea that he was doing it. And now he decides to go with the jump angle with the Nova. I mean, I don't even think the Nova's accurate jumping at that range.
Yeah, let's see. Let's find out. Maybe we're about to witness something magical here. Flash comes out. Remux finds Freddy towards drop down. I'm just like tunnel visioned on this Nova play. He hasn't hit a bullet, and he's shot three thus far. He gets tagged up a little bit. Maybe that'll teach him not peek. No, nope, Monty puts him down as he attempted to hop up under the wall, and they give a hard a pick that someone worked very hard for. They give one up right back, 4-4.
Baker, though, his position's good at middle, and he does have Ladier to play off of, but RDO checks it and checks the bomb site. And those were the two main threats this round for Isuba. They've been dealt with. And yeah, we got Remux. He gets a pick over towards the B side. Constantly jump peeking with a Nova. And yeah, the bullets weren't even close. It doesn't make too much sense how the Mag 7 is dead center. And the Nova just kind of flies wherever it pleases when you're jumping. And how is a shotgun one of the most least accurate weapons while jumping, Chad?
Right. What game are we playing right now?
More accurate than the Nova.
Yeah, and you're like, yeah, it makes no sense, really. If anything, like you had stated, you would think that those ones would be all right across the board, but not so much. And MNL not able to get much done there, but would have been cool. I would have loved to see a flying Nova kill, but just wasn't meant to be in that round. So 11-2-6, Isuba, and picking that one up for Spy not working out for the Leisure side. And moving into this next round, we've got another... Does Remux keep this Nova or give it back to MNL is my question.
Keep it.
He's like, no, you don't get it back, buddy.
I think that's what's been decided, too. So Light and Remux, only two players without pistols. We'll see where Remux tries his luck with the Nova. I'll go towards drop down. I like that more than just playing a Mag 7 angle, pretty much. Towards the broken wall, but Light, the only other player with more than a pistol. He's gone down at middle, and I think Henke is still posting up on that weapon. Doesn't want to let anybody retrieve it. Faker might go for it. And Isuba just posting on this slow, methodical, spread out take and hoping that Leisure will push them. They've already given them one frag. Pretty likely that Leisure would peek out aggressively and try to, you know, get the number advantage down from Isuba. And then Nova towards drop down does spot out one, but very little intel given by Isuba on like where their positions are, because they're just holding everywhere. And Leisure, they're taking some peeks here and there, but Isuba, I mean, they can't get much intel off of this.
And BenQ's made his way into the B bomb site, and I think that's why the rotation's being called for here. He spots out MNL towards the rectangle, but other than that, he's basically cleared all the way to Chicken Coop and does find that frag. So that's basically it in that, well, Leisure, they can attempt to retake back through connector, but considering their weaponry, it's not going to pan out so well. Versus the AKs, they will reign supreme, and now Remux. Come on, buddy. See the Nova in full force? Not going to be so. RDO takes him down, and full five left up for the T side.
Looking at this buy from Leisure, not going to have full utility because of the force buy that they had went for. And that's pretty important towards the B side. I'm wondering, Isuba, I don't think they're looking towards B, but if your opponents do go for a force buy, and you win if you're the T side in this said situation. If you go towards B quickly, I'm thinking about it, there's guaranteed to be less mollies that you're going to have to deal with, at least early on after your opponents had gone for the forest buy. Not going to get to see that, though. That's Ben Q. Wow, solo out broken wall. No flash coverage, nothing like that. He just goes out, fights for intel, tries to get an opening pick, but instead he donates it over towards the Leisure side and the rest of Isuba. They're just going to run out mid.
I think Vladir spotted some feet here, and yeah, him and Faker combined able to spam down Monty. So now a 3-on-5. Leisure looking to take their 12th, but they will give up One back in the other direction, light. Like he was very pushed up, yeah. Trying to make his way towards New Halls and clear out entire real estate. But to be fair, they still have a 4-on-3 here for Leisure, and that intel that they were coming back. Well, to be fair, there's still a lot of time left in the round, but still, lots of damage dealt, and Vladimir will find another one.
Kind of unimpressed with the strat there from Isuba. They had the guy run out Broken Wall. If he's successful and he gets a kill, I mean, is his plan to fall back or just maintain control of Broken Wall? Because there wasn't any utility being used, and if you're going to try to fake or make it seem like there's more numbers there than there actually is, probably drop a smoke or something like that, or flash into the bombsite, anything. And I mean, that smoke gives you room to just sit on the Broken Wall and make it seem like there's more guys there. But him just running in and dying, and then your second part of the strat is to have four people running through mid. I don't see the big picture with the strat.
Yeah, it's definitely... It was an odd one. No doubt about that. I guess there's the unexpected aspect, but that's pretty much the only thing that you can... Like you can say about that, just one person just randomly running out on the wall. But anyhow, it's going to be Leisure able to pick up this round. Three players left up as well, so the economy gets some minor growth going. But Isuba will be able to buy into this next one, and we'll see. They could reset the economy of the CT side here.
And I think they're gonna need to. If Leisure can take this one. Isuba's buying the round following, depending on if they get a plant, will be a little shaky. Maybe Leisure can close it out from there, but Isuba, yeah, this is the reset they're looking for. So this round, huge for both teams. Three towards B, two at A, four Leisure, one mid, one long. Rest scattered out of the B bomb site. Isuba, I guess I like that they're going into a more default style. That first gun round was interesting, to be nice about it. I'll still just post it up on the Broken, spamming away, hoping that Leisure will give them anything, any sound cue, any peaks, anything like that. And shifting up the setup at middle for Leisure, though, as they've fallen the player off a long, gone back to mid. I kind of like that. There's a lot of teams that will fight for that long control early, so by shifting around this point back towards middle, you know, you could figure it'd be about 10, 20 seconds before you have to start considering that a threat again. This is Suba. Since no entries, they've gotten no entries, where are they going to go with this? And I'm still unsure. Is the bomb still at New Halls?
Yeah, they're spread out enough that in theory they could still head either way, but now the bomb definitely grouping up towards B. RDO is still off towards A, and he's got a full nade set as well, which is intriguing. I can't imagine... I don't know what he does with those in a post-plant scenario. He's going to lurk through at some point here as the B-bomb site is tempted to be taken. Light does fall. Can't get anything done, but the rest of his squad coming up fairly big, and the flank was dealt with RDO. So it's Freddy and BenQ to try and get it done. Can't in the end. And Leisure take their 13th. And another round that I feel like that was a situation where they were just... basically dedicated to finding a pick, and when it didn't happen, again, I was very confused at RDO. If you've got a player with a full nade set and you didn't use it by that point and he was alone A, I don't know. I don't know if you've got more to say on that.
Yeah, it kind of makes me think the way they're set up. Generally on the T side, there's reasons that you'll buy. There's like very specific reasons that you'll buy your nades for takes and such, instead of just buying them to maybe have them later on in the round. Maybe that was the case. Maybe you just wanted to save them for later. But to me, it's a tell that it's not all that meticulously crafted on this T side.
Yeah.
And one way to go about that is let's just rush into B, and both teams finding a ton of success the first time they do it.
Yeah, RDO finding Remux there. And now it's only Lydirux, and he does find one. Pinky brought down to a single hit point as well, but I think this should be the end of things, as that was actually a pretty cute pop flash that did blind RDO. Does take the duel, drops RDO down to 12, but he wins it on that T side, and four left up. Isuba, they're still in this. They do bust up the economy. Leisure was not quite comfortable.
Yeah, that was a big one for them. And looking at that money of the CT side next round, I suppose they'll get a good buy, but not a ton of utility on a couple players, if my math is correct. And since Isuba just found phenomenal success with that B-side rush, I think it's going to change the dynamic of our next gun round quite a bit. Because now Leisure obviously have to be worried about that, but then it puts the option over to Isuba. Do they think we're going to go B again? Can we play off of that? Can we run a little fake B and then go towards the A-side? It really opens up a lot of options when you have that amount of success with such a simple play like a B-rush.
Faker's going to find RDO, so they are able to kind of get a quick flank in rotation. We'll see if that comes into play here. Depends how long they can hold on inside of the bomb site. MNL now the last kind of bit of defense as he will fall. Freddy heading back towards drop. Vladir's jumping around like crazy. And at this point, Faker, he's just going to hang out with that AK back towards A. And the remaining players with their banana 5.7s. Just going to try and find some exit frags.
The monkey business. I like that skin. I don't have it anymore, though. You know how it goes, Chad. Everything goes away eventually. All my skins.
All good things come to an end.
It's just magic. I don't know how it happens. Maybe I have a problem, Chad. I need help.
Yeah, that's one way of looking at it. Just bad luck. You'll get it back.
Just blame genetics. I had a strong predisposition to getting addicted to betting.
There you go. Well, it's going to be 13-10. Isuba getting their double digits here. So it is turning into a pretty close map. Number one, Leisure. Definitely had a lot going for them. But credit to Isuba. They've definitely brought it back.
Wow, they're going to save.
Now within three. Interesting. Yeah, I guess they're just a little... They still do have some rounds to work with, but this will close things up even closer. To be fair, Faker does have an opportunity to get some frags with that AK and at least keep the economy in check for Isuba. But if that's not the case, and Isuba is able to run away with this round with quite a few left up, that gives him a great shot.
So you don't see this decision made as often anymore in Go, but Leisure, they really want full utility. They could have got full M4s out across the board, especially with that AK in the hands of Faker. So they want everything in that next gun round. And that's kind of falling out of fashion here in Go. But anyways, Isuba towards the B-bomb site. Leisure actually finding a bunch of kills with these 5-7. Back at him. 2-2. Bomb site still attempted by Isuba towards B, but there's not enough numbers taking in. It's 1-for-1. The trades are going back and forth. Now Vladir, he has a chance. Isuba quite low.
Yeah, both very, very low. As you stated, Flash not effective at all. Actually flashes his side of the door, but he finds the frag as he jumps around and makes himself a difficult target. Gotta get that flashbang as well. And keep playing such a close, aggressive angle. Vladir, wow. No way to expect that.
That's a perfect example of how if you make a play that in theory is you're giving your opponent a much better chance, but it's so hard to predict if you're set opponent because it's so brazen and almost too risky in a way. But Leisure now finally have saved up for everything that they want, and they're gonna go with the double op. That's the answer. I guess they don't want to give up any opening picks, but when you have this double op, more susceptible to a rush. But Isuba, they want to go ahead and slow it down once more, and I think this is going to pander to the ops.
Ooh, Vladir had a shot to hit on RDO, actually whiffs two. And it was actually a shot where they actually had no one watching long A on the T side. Both players outside of A middle seemed to be watching that lower area. So Vladir actually had all the time in the world to line up that shot, but it's the scenario where he spotted someone, he's like, just tries to hit the flex shot, doesn't hit it. But that being said, Light does find one towards the broken wall area, and that's the op out of commission for the T side.
Yeah, they're both boosted up on the opposite sides of broken wall. I think Freddy's hips just a bit wider. It was spotted out by Light. Or as I like to call him, Ait. So preparing for the drop down play with the player outside of mid, that's RDO. So they may turn this into an A-side split. There's still two ops up in Vladir. He's watching the bottom of mid, outblast his teammate. Well, whoops there. But RDO finishes off that teammate as he tries to push into mid. So Leisure in the 5-on-4 really wanted to know if it's going to be the B play. And now Leisure, the defense is beginning to move about based upon the amount of pressure applied at drop. And I think Leisure is quite confused on where this is going to be.
Yeah, definitely. Vladir goes down. Monty wins his duel versus Remux. And Still very interesting round unfolding. MNL might be able to deny the bomb plant here, depending on how this pans out. 5 seconds, and he will jump on up. Can't find the frag on RDO. He does have his teammate coming up middle, but Monty finds the frag before Light. Light was taking all his... Wow, I'm so surprised that he couldn't kill him before he killed his teammate. Anyhow, 1v2. Send out Nate up and pepper up RDO a little bit, but being that he is running up with his AWP, now switches to the 5-7. Beautiful
sick
flashbang. And now on a one-on-one.
Can he find the final target, RDO? He's playing this wisely, creeping around this site. It's just a guessing game now, but makes a bit of noise. But it's a fake. RDO, oh, he goes down. And Light, I think he just has enough time to get this defuse. What a clutch from the Leisure player. That is disastrous for Isuba and a misplay in the end. Just a few more seconds. That's all it would have taken.
Definitely. And going back to that again, Light coming up on the flank. And him taking down Monty, but Monty killing his teammate right before. Like, Alight seemed to have his scope on the target, but he just wanted to make for certain that he hit the target that wasn't looking at him. But again, in the midst of all that, his teammate goes down. Luckily, he clutches in the end. 4K in a beautiful round. So anyhow, 14-11. Leisure, we'll see if they can close out this map.
You know, there's so many circumstantial things that happen in that round. Like, if Light kills him faster, and if that flat, if the guys defending the bomb site were more prepared for that flashbang, because it's really good for the player on the opposite side of APC, but that flash is easily read by the guy inside of the site. So I think there should have been a trade there, but that's one of those ifs. Now went into Leisure winning the round again. This is pretty much Isuba's last chance. They can't afford to get reset in this situation. And both the economy-wise as well as the round count. But Light does give up the first frag, continuing to get aggressive on the broken wall. So we'll see how Isuba works from the advantage. But Leisure looking to take it back from long.
Yeah, I'm surprised Light went for that. We're going to see another frag given up towards long A. But Light had, I think, 15 HP, and he wanted to work the edge of a smoke on broken wall. Just... interesting stuff. That being said, Vladir and MNL bringing it back a little bit, 2-on-3, but Henki and Monty finding frags, so it's only Vladir, and with 20 hit points, he is walking in that direction, but I can't imagine he can get much going here. Flashes through the connector door, avoided though from Henki, and 14-12. This will continue and be very close considering the amount of money we see on the CT side. Completely reset yet again.
Yep, and that's probably going to make it 14-14. And then Isuba might have a bank built up by then. So the four spy out from the CTs, and wow, they invest damn near everything. So they know they're facing a double save. They had a lot of success with pistols in the last round like this, so they're gonna go for it again in Isuba. It's back to the B rush. Haven't seen it all that much, but it has been extremely effective both times. And yeah, that is a slaughter at B.
Yeah, that's pretty unfortunate for Leisure considering their investment into the round, because now it's going to be 14-13 and have 2 rounds worth of loss bonus, and that's pretty much it moving into this next round. So I imagine they will not do that again, and they'll commit to the save and then buy when it's 14-14, I suppose. And again, this has gotten all the way to pretty much a tie scoreline. Obviously, I'm skipping around a little bit, but Isuba taking that round very convincingly.
And since they went with the full force buy, I thought, you know, maybe some, since you're going to double save, maybe some tech, or not tech nines, 5-7s, maybe a nade or two for a drop or broken wall. But by going for the full invest, then you're cutting into the round that is, that's your final chance. And the round after this one, I should say. And even buying a bit lower, like Remux getting a nade in this situation, it doesn't seem like a lot, and it may seem like I'm nitpicking, but you have 3 rounds of loss bonus and $1,700 coming into the next round. That's not enough to hold off like a broken wall play, or say Isuba rushes B again, and there's not gonna be a ton of utility there for Leisure. However, Isuba, they haven't hit the B bomb site when the utility is lacking on a gun round yet. And I don't expect them to do so, though I do think it would be a good play.
And we'll see how that does pan out eventually. As we can see, the nades are towards Broken Wall. Actually, MNL has his in the drop-down area. Hasn't pulled it out just yet, as we've got a very slow look from the T side. RDO focused on long A, as Vlidir has pushed that quite a few times. So don't blame him at all. And looks like Vlidir going to be doing it again as he peeks on out, slowly checking angles one by one. Spots a player though and just gets out of there. Doesn't want anything to do with that duel. Mikio versus USP, not exactly a good situation. So falls back to middle, and the bit of intel, not much. You saw a player holding the flank. It's kind of something that happens quite often on the T side, as we see nades raiding into B, but the bomb's still in new halls.
Heavy, heavy fake thrown with utility, not so much numbers. Vladir pushed up, finds the dink. Oh, he might even be able to get the AK. RDO denies that. That should be the round. That's probably the user's only chance. They didn't have upgraded pistols here. In the back of the bomb site, they have made it into the site, though. And that can be one of the bigger problems trying to retake into this A bomb site, is just getting out of the window and getting out of the double doors. It's often just a funnel that wrecks you, especially if there's any utility up. But wow, light. Ooh, turns around. Okay, does bring down Monty. Expensive, doesn't matter at this point. Yasuba has enough money where they'll buy out for the rest in this round, and even if Leisure win this one. So let's look at that economy of Leisure. Is that enough to defend a B play? I guess so, but no kits, no head armor, and I'd really like to see Yasuba just go for it again.
Yeah, and no incendiaries. Honestly, incendiaries, you can hold off Broken Wall, you can hold off Drop Down. There's so many places that those could be useful on that CT side.
Of course, they'll use a smoke.
No kits, so yeah, no doubt. As we'll see Yasuba, if they play this the way they probably should, they should bait out some of those nades. Again, not a ton to work with on the Leisure end, as we will see the slow play from Yasuba. One towards Drop, two towards Broken Wall, two off towards A, watching for the pushes. So nothing crazy going on. Just again, a nice slow round from them. And all kind of comes down to this, as well. I guess the T side, they do have the economy to push this to overtime if they lose this round, but CT side, definitely not.
Yeah, this is Leisure's last chance. And, you know, I got a question. There was not a single B rush stopped this entire map one. So, surprising that the teams wouldn't attempt it more. But anyways, that was the decision made. Walking out mid. Oh no, Leisure don't have anybody spotting it. And another man is rotating over for Leisure. So if Yasuba timed this right, they could sell the hell out of this fake. There's one more player from Yasuba making his way back towards the B bomb site. And now, gonna make some noise if you're RDO. If anybody else rotates, Leisure is in a lot of trouble.
And we will see RDO just sprints through a long A smoke. No one rotating out, as the B bomb site a bunch to be under siege here. And we'll see how this pans out. Monty onto light. So 4-on-4. They're kind of caught in the smoke towards the rock. Freddy peeks from drop. Can't win his fight though. So 4-on-3. Monty taking a lot of damage and falls in the end. BenQ will take one fight versus Faker and wins that. Henke onto MNL. 2-on-2 in the post plant without any defuse kits on the CT side.
Henke makes it back into the coop. That's really big. He got one out of his off position. Now he can just play off of BenQ. Oh, they line up for him at rectangle, but it's all up to Henke. They're trying to spam through. They might be wasting their time. Somebody's got to tap the bomb. Henke peeks out, but instead he gets traded. And I think there's just enough time left on the bomb.
Indeed. So Leisure going to be able to take it here. To be fair, they only survive with one, so their economy's not going to be fantastic moving into the 30th round. And that's kind of what I was highlighting early in that last round, in that, yeah, Yasuba, look at their money. They've got more than enough to get a full buy moving into this, and you almost favor them with the amount of utility that they're going to have versus how much Leisure will have yet again. You see a Mag 7 and a P90 from us as well, so not looking too hot.
Chat, not a single B rush has been stopped, and we've only seen it three times. That just triggers me. Anyways. Right.
Maybe it's that they're just like, they feel so fortunate that it's worked out. It's like, we don't want to like challenge our luck too much on it. I have no idea, but I agree.
But all the B rushes, they weren't even close.
Yeah. I don't know, man.
It's just murder. I don't know. Maybe it's like a respect thing. You don't rush B, we won't rush B only when we need to. Even though we won't do it when the match is coming to a close. Anyways, Yasuba have gotten the entry pick. And that gets us closer to potential overtime. It's one man outside of A for Leisure. He's actually pushed down into middle. If he pushes any further, that could decide the round whether he can... Oh, man. Light next target at the B-bomb site. And he tries to fight towards Broken. And that's going to force everybody to fall back to the B-bomb site for Leisure. And I think this is the right decision. Just stack it.
Just a note, M&L doesn't have armor. I didn't actually recognize that till now. He opts to go with utility. So we'll see if that game punch comes into play. He needs to play again accordingly. Faker finds Monty, creates a 3-on-4. And Freddy wins. Actually, sorry, Freddy doesn't win the duel versus M&L. M&L gets that flawlessly, again without armor, but they've pulled a rotation on that T side. Back over to A, and we got a foot race.
I think Isuba already have a guy inside of the site. Oh, Hanky, they have no idea that he's there. Actually, Remux, he did find him. But still, Isuba with the frag. Now, with disadvantage, should be able to just guide it on home. Trying to run out of the crawl space and through middle. Faker goes down, and we're going to overtime.
Overtime it is. As, again, Leisure, you could see, they're so ill-equipped moving into that last round. So, M&L, again, has an AK, but opts for utility. Doesn't go with armor and such, and yeah, we will be going to overtime. Again, this is Leisure's map choice. First map here of this best of three. Cash is going to be map number two. Mirage the third if we need it. I'm just waiting for these guys to ready up, and trying to think of who I favor moving into the next half. I got to feel Isuba. Like, it's going to be a battle a bit of T-sides, I feel. And if Isuba can just keep playing the way they've been playing, more or less. Leisure has been able to make work. I'm trying to think. They saved heavily for that one round where they got that double op and they won that one, but then lost the one they're after. And they're reset again, so there wasn't a lot going for them. And we'll see if Isuba can take another couple of rounds here, or three in total, to win out that T-side.
Yeah, I think I favor Isuba more. I feel like Leisure's been playing more loose on that CT side, and Isuba's been able to punish more. Both sides' T-side decision-making has not impressed me. Isuba, we've seen a couple strats from them that haven't worked. Well, they'll send one guy, I think it was RDO last time, where it's like a solo fake, but the way in which they commit to it, there's just no other options to what like a second part or a contingency plan to the strat. Last time it was RDO, runs out of a smoke long, and Leisure, we saw it towards the, what was it, the B-bomb site too. If that single man goes down and the rest of the players are smoked out or mollied out towards the other bomb site, I've seen that twice now where Isuba just crumble to that. So I hope they don't go to a strat like that. I hope they go with the B-rush, because one B-rush has not been stopped, and there's only been three attempted. So, I mean, come on, Chad. Math.
Right. Pretty decent odds if you're asking us. Well, it does look like we've got... It looks like it's subsided at this point. A little bit of high ping on one of the players. BenQ's still back up there. It's at about 100 ping, so I'm not really certain what's going on, but I believe that's what's preventing the ready up from going on. So, anyhow, get that lovely server message that CLG vs Envious is starting. Also on Cobblestone, as we have some overtime here on Cobblestone. Again, Leisure's map choice. And we're almost there to ready up. BenQ's ping looks satisfactory at this point. Back down to 40. So I imagine in just a moment we will go live and get some answers to our questions as to how this is going to play out. As I had to favor Leisure again moving into the second half, but they just couldn't get much done after swapping. And being that it was their map choice, that is a little bit more surprising than when it's not your map choice, that's for certain.
Definitely. I do remember Leisure on cash not being all that bad. So, I mean, if they could take this one, I don't think all is lost for them, even though Isuba is having a good showing on Leisure's map choice. So, the adjustment that I'd like to see from Leisure, tighten up towards the B-bomb site. And sometimes Light's been getting the pick there, sometimes he doesn't. At least M&L is not making strange plays in recent times, which did give up a couple of rounds early. And if you're Isuba, if Leisure doesn't give them any of the opening picks, when it's been a 5-on-5 scenario, it's not like Isuba has looked extraordinary from that position. So I'd really like to see Leisure don't go for any entries Maybe a couple. Of course, it's tempting, but I think that's what's mostly what's been getting them in trouble, and mostly what's been getting Isuba these T side rounds. And also, somebody rush B.
Right. Yeah, I think we just need to see a B rush, so you are appeased by it. At the moment, we're still just waiting for BenQ's. Ping's going all over the place, and it was kind of funny to see. Remux is like, how long do you want to wait? And they're like, till it lowers. It's like, okay. Alrighty. I guess.
That's settled.
That's how that's going to go then. Alright. Well, yes, we got to allow for that. There is obviously some time limits on how long they're able to take, but they do still have some time in theory. So we'll wait it on out. But I guess talking about cash a little bit, I do remember Leisure, like you were highlighting earlier when we first started the map. I do remember them as well. I can't remember how many of these players are the same from that lineup, though. If maybe they all are, I'm uncertain. I don't
definitely remember, not all.
I don't remember Light, to be honest, because I feel like we would have made that
MNL.
I remember MNL.
I feel like I remember Remux.
Yeah, maybe Vladir as well. Maybe not Faker. I feel like I would have remembered a Faker, being that, like, not that I'm in the league, but like any player that just, you're in a different game, but you have the alias of someone that's a god in another game, you just kind of like to mentally note that. So I feel like maybe not so much him. Maybe I'm wrong, though. As, yeah, anyhow. I do remember on cash, though, they weren't an awful team, no doubt. I think that they'll have a decent showing over there as well. But again, we're just waiting for these guys. As we can see, Remux is now he's pulling out the rule book. Says he's awarded 1 5-minute tactical timeout per hour. Oh, this is technically technical, so. Technically technical, Laser. So we're live and over.
Got it. All right, he is. And his ping goes up the moment we start. Right. Just let the round start. Don't pause it. Let's see. Are they going to let it rock?
It goes back down. Yeah, it seems just to be spiking. And again, that's, I have no idea. There could be a number of different issues, but we're live into things.
Right, wow, off the rule book on him. That's great. I think he misread it. Definitely 5 minutes for tactical, not technical. Right. Although for ping, that seems like a lot more like fixable from the player's end. I don't know. And is this the B rush I'm looking for? There it is, Chad, and watch it get wrecked.
What? Yeah, Light has a SCAR 20. We didn't see a single SCAR 20 throughout all of regulation, and he does let go of a couple bullets starting to spam through. How many can he get? Only one, as that was very anticlimactic. Remux and Faker taking a lot of damage as we see a 4-on-3, and Leisure almost look out of the round at this point.
What do you know, Chad?
The B-Rush works.
They rush B, it works out beautifully, even though Leisure were ready there with the auto. Round's not over, though. Two members wounded, Remux and Faker. Vladirox, the only guy with full HP. And they are going to be committing Freddy on the off angle towards Broken Wall. The rest of the players trying to come out of drop down and White Rock. I think Freddy just peeked out a bit too much. Oh yeah, Faker brings him down, but the rest of his squad has already fallen inside of the bomb site. Yeah, B-Rush, just shocking.
Wow, they actually picked up the SCAR 20. I'm actually very surprised that the T-side opted to keep that in play. Like, how much can you really get done on the T-side with that weapon? Maybe if Monty goes and he goes up in, like, that Rapunzel window and then just watches a middle and then has an AK with him that he can go back and grab and leaves it up there. That would probably be the only play I actually agree with. But, well,
if you can get it broken wall into a post-plant position, then it becomes really strong. But, I mean, it's not that good of a weapon to take into a bomb site with.
I guess it's good for this. Just, like, there's a smoke down. It's like, well, I'm just going to spam towards the end of the platform. That's pretty terrifying for Leisure. I don't think you want to boost any player up there when you got someone spamming that SCAR 20.
Probably not. Pretty good weapon at shooting through smokes. There is a player testing his luck, though. Who's that brave soul? Oh, it's Remux. I was thinking it was more of a MNL type play.
Right.
MNL does burn a bit towards the drop, but kind of a lull in the action this round. Isuba taking it more passively. MNL gets caught out towards drop, and that opens up room for this auto.
And they find another one, actually. Lidir yet again gets caught out as RDO seems to have his number towards long A. Remux does fire back, but in the midst of this, they have called for an A-side play. Freddy hopping up. And Light was literally staring at Connector Door out of smoke as he fled out of the drop down area. Remux does frag back, but one on three, and that smoke is down without a kit. This is a safe scenario, is the only real situation where you have very low buys in an overtime situation is basically the one we're entering into right now. Leisure buying two in a row, and they've got very little to work with. Isuba looking to win out their T side, and it does look like we will have that battle to the T sides.
Put him away with the B rush.
Right. And let's get it done.
Even though Isuba won that round, I still wasn't impressed with the decision making on the T side, because they have the auto like walk through a smoke as a fake attempt. When, I mean, you could just spam that gun and fall back and you'll have the same results, and maybe even in a post plan. I don't think there's much reason to give away your life in that spot. And they go with the B rush. However, this time, Leisure close up with the Mag 7 as Faker. And finally, a B rush has been stopped. Although, again, Isuba, like, what was the point of that mid guy?
Yeah, I really don't know. He runs towards middle, he gets one deked by Ladir and loses his gun, and then the rest towards D. Well, they had to put the brakes on Freddy and BenQ as they did not want to feed even more. You can see two perfectly lined up bodies essentially in the exact same spot on Broken Wall. Fell victim to the mag. Faker pushes though, and any of this kind of aggression is